Hello to all my good friends at Finch Academy. Today, I want to talk about one of the most important topics in breeding and keeping ornamental birds, like finches and canaries, common diseases, and their proper treatments. Many bird owners rush to use medicines as soon as they hear a couple of drug names without realizing that wrong medication or dosage can seriously harm their birds. So stay with me until the end of this video because I'll not only show you the common medications used, but also explain when it's absolutely necessary to involve a veterinarian. If this topic interests you, hit the subscribe button and the bell icon right now so you won't miss future videos. Part 1. What to do immediately when your bird gets sick. The first step is always isolation. Separate the sick bird into another cage. Then, clean and disinfect the main environment completely and replace the food and water containers. It's very helpful to take photos or videos of the bird, especially of its droppings or crop area, as they help with diagnosis. And please remember, if your bird is breathing heavily or losing balance, that's an emergency. Take it to the vet immediately. Part 2. Mites and lice. One of the most common finch problems is mite infestation. Signs include excessive scratching, ruffled feathers, and small red dots on the skin. Treatment starts with thorough cage disinfection. Throw away infested nests. Then use anti-mite sprays or medications specifically for birds. A drug called Exalt is well known in poultry use, but for small birds, you must consult a vet. Sometimes ivermectin is prescribed under veterinary supervision. Part 3. Internal parasites. If your bird is losing weight, has watery droppings, and seems weak, it might have internal parasites. Medications like levamisil are used in bird breeding, but the dosage is extremely sensitive. Never medicate on your own. Take a fecal sample to a lab and follow the vet's dosage exactly. Part 4. Coccidiosis. This disease often causes bloody or green diarrhea. The bird becomes dull and inactive. Common treatments include Baycox or Toltrazerol. But remember, these are registered for poultry, so for finches, the dose must be adjusted precisely by a vet. Sometimes sulfa drugs are used also. If you've found the video helpful so far, please hit the like button. It tells me these lessons are useful for you. Part 5. Crop infection. Sometimes food stays in the crop. It swells or emits a bad smell. This is usually caused by candida yeast. A common mistake is giving sulfa drugs, which don't work against fungus. The correct treatment involves antifungal medications such as nystatin or fluconazole, prescribed by a vet. In some cases, crop flushing may also be necessary. Part 6. Eye problems. If your bird's eye is closed or has discharge, it's likely a bacterial infection. Use special bird eye drops or ointments. Never use human medicine without expert advice. Always consult a vet directly. Part 7. Respiratory infections. If the bird's tail bobs while breathing or its beak stays open, it may have a respiratory infection. A commonly used medicine is doxycycline, especially for chlamydia infections, but treatment must be long-term and strictly supervised by a vet. Part 8. Chick mortality. Many breeders face chick deaths. Products like Syria powder, which combine vitamins and probiotics, can help strengthen chicks. However, remember that supplements only support health. The root cause of death must be identified and fixed. Part 9. Nutritional Deficiencies. If your bird eats droppings, likely vitamin B deficiency, give B complex. If it loses balance or falls, it needs trace minerals plus B complex. Irregular molting or feather loss, give amino acids plus vitamin A. Undigested seeds and droppings, usually liver or digestion issues, use liver support supplements, not grit. Bird constantly breathing with open beak is likely a respiratory issue, not vitamin deficiency. Take it to the vet immediately. Summary. So, we've learned the main disease symptoms and the common medications used for each. Always remember, poultry medicines like Baycox and Exalt should only be used for pet birds under veterinary supervision. And never, ever medicate on your own. Dosages differ greatly and can be fatal for small birds. If you haven't subscribed yet, do it now. And trust me, you'll find it very useful. Also, leave me a comment. What problems have your birds faced most often? Parasites or respiratory diseases? Your feedback helps me choose the next topic. Thanks for watching till the end. I hope your birds stay healthy and full of energy. Until the next video, take care and goodbye.